In this video, I'll show how to install OpenSSH Server on Windows 10 and set up public key authentication from Linux and Windows. I'll use two VirtualBox machines, Windows 10 and Debian Linux. This install of Debian is without a GUI. It works the same with a GUI. Just open a terminal and follow the same steps. We'll begin at the Windows 10 virtual machine. I'm logged in as user William. This user is an administrator. This is important. I'll show why in a bit. To install OpenSSH Server on Windows, go to Settings, Apps, click Optional Features, click Add a Feature. In the search input, enter SSH. There it is. Enable the checkbox and install. The binaries end up in the Windows directory, but we don't need to touch any of that. All configuration files appear under Program Data. Once installing is done, close Settings. Open File Explorer, and in the address bar, enter percent program data percent. This exposes the hidden folder program data. There is a folder SSH. Note this folder does not begin with a dot, like SSH in the user folder or on Linux. Go into the folder and you'll see it's empty at this point. The first time running the SSH server, it will set up the default configuration files. SSH runs as a service, and it doesn't start by default. Right-click the Start menu and choose Computer Management. At the bottom, open the section Services and Applications. Select Services. Scroll down to find OpenSSH SSH Server. Double-click to open Properties. The default is manual startup. Likely you'll want it to run anytime the machine boots. Change the startup type to automatic and start it. Click OK to close the properties. Don't close the computer management window. Just minimize. We'll be back here a few times. Now you can see the SSH folder has some content. Let's try it out. First, we need to know this machine's IP address. Go to Settings, Network and Internet. The primary connection is listed first. For me, it's Ethernet, likely the same for you. Click the button Properties and scroll to the bottom. There's the IP. Take note of it and close Settings. If you have a DNS server and client set to register, you can also use the host name. I'll keep it simple and use the IP. At the Debian virtual machine, SSH to the Windows machine. There's a message about authenticity of host can't be established. Answer yes. Enter the password and you're in. But we want to connect with a public key, not a password. Exit the SSH connection. Having connected to a server, the .ssh directory should now exist. Change directory to it. cd space .ssh and list it. All I have is known hosts. If there are files id underscore rsa and id underscore rsa.pub, you already have a key. In that case, skip the keygen step next. To create a key, enter ssh-keygen. You're prompted to answer a few questions. Enter file in which to save the key. Press Enter to use the default location. Enter passphrase. This step is optional, but recommended for better security. For this key, I'll leave it blank. Then confirm the passphrase, or enter if none. And you're done. List the directory again. There should now be files id_rsa and id_rsa.pub. The first is the private key. The second is the public key. That's what we'll send to the server. But where it goes depends on the kind of user. Recall earlier I mentioned I'm an administrator because it changes the file destination. Normal users store keys in the user folder. I won't show doing that because I can't imagine giving non-admin users SSH access to any server. Administrators store keys under the program data folder. Enter SCP:\_rsa.pub:\William@192.168.3.140:%\programdata%\ssh. Of course, substitute your username and IP. Input the password, and it's sent. You can see it on the Windows machine. For normal users, keys go in the file authorized_keys. Not the same for administrators. The file name is administrators_authorized_keys. Note administrators is plural. At the Debian machine, SSH to Windows again. Change directory to the SSH folder under program data. CD:\programdata%\SSH. Now add the key. Type id_rsa.pub:\administrators_authorized_keys. At the Windows machine, you'll see the file has been created, but it needs specific permissions or none of this works. This only has to be done once, the first time the file is created. Capitalization is critical. Enter exactly as shown. \id_rsa.pub:\administrators_authorized_keys\ Press Enter. The R for inheritance is to remove it. Then only two users are given permission, administrators and system. The F after each is full control. Note, administrators is plural, both the file name and the grant option. At Windows, the security properties should now be restricted. That is correct. At Debian, exit SSH. Go to the Windows machine and we'll edit the SSH configuration file. Now open Notepad, but elevated with admin access. In the search box, enter Note. Notepad should come up. Right-click and select Run as Administrator. Go to the File menu and select Open. In the address bar, input %programdata%\ssh. Change the file type to All Files. Open SSHD_config. Find the line pub key authentication. Uncomment the line and make sure it's set to yes. Save the file, but don't close Notepad. Minimize it for now. We'll be back in a bit. Restore computer management. We need to restart the SSH server. Click the button above or the link Restart. Minimize the window. We'll be back again later. Go back to the Debian machine and SSH to Windows. If all goes well, there is no password prompt. But if the key had a passphrase applied, there is that. Either way, the user is authenticated using the public key. At Debian, exit SSH. We're done here. The last step is to disable password authentication, but not before adding other users. I want to show the difference for a user with a public key already. Here is my SSH folder on my actual Windows machine. I have a key already set up to access Linux servers on my network. I don't want a new key, or I have to set up all those servers again. So I'll use the existing key instead of a new one. In Windows Terminal, skip the keygen step and send the current key to the Windows virtual machine. Change directory to .ssh. Then send the key file. scp space id underscore rsa dot pub space william at 192.168.3.140 colon percent program data percent slash ssh. First time connecting, respond yes to add the server to known hosts. Now SSH to the Windows virtual machine. Change directory to SSH under program data. CD space percent program data percent slash SSH. Then like before, append the key uploaded. Type space ID underscore RSA dot pub space right angle bracket space administrators underscore authorized underscore keys. Exit SSH and try it again. Instead of password, I'm authenticated with the key. Exit SSH. Go to the Windows virtual machine and restore Notepad. Now disable password authentication. Scroll down a bit and find password authentication. Uncomment the line and the next, permit empty passwords, and change password authentication from yes to no. Save. Restore computer management and restart the SSH server. It works from my Windows machine and Debian. If this solution works for you, like the video and subscribe to this channel. It keeps more videos coming.